I'm Robert Cameron, and I've come down to this riverbank today to show you how to do a banded snail hunt. And what we have to do is firstly learn to recognize the species we're interested in, to tell them apart from other species, and how to go looking for them. So we'll make a start. These snails can be found in lots of different habitats, like hedges or woods, but something like this, a riverbank with some nettles and reeds, is absolutely ideal for them. They really like this kind of place. But I think we'll be lucky and find something here. So, this is a good habitat to look at, and if you're lucky, snails sometimes are sitting on the vegetation. And if you peer gently, don't knock the vegetation too hard or they may fall off. And we just go along having a look. And yes, look, under these reeds, there's quite a number. And I can see both the species we're interested in straight off. And we'll have a look at them in more detail later. But you can see how they're clustering on the undersides of the leaves. Of course, not all the snails will be climbing up the vegetation. Some of them will be sitting on the ground, and it's also perfectly possible to use empty shells, so long as they're nice and fresh. So I'm going to have a scrout around on the ground underneath the vegetation and see what I can find. And yes, here's one live one I found immediately. And here, just on the edge, there are some dead shells. But you can see that they're quite brightly coloured, so we can score them very easily. And indeed, you can keep the dead shells as a collection for yourself if you want. The two species we're interested in are Cepaea hortensis and Cepaea nemerealis. And I've just found a Cepaea hortensis here, and I know it's a Cepaea hortensis because it's a shell with a white lip to the mouth. But here is a Cepaea nemerealis, the other species we're interested in. And you can see very obviously that it's got a black lip, or very dark brown, round the mouth of the shell. And that's the most reliable way of telling the two species apart. One problem that we have is that, of course, there are not only the adult shell snails I showed you just now, of course there are babies. And because the babies don't have a lip, we can't tell which species they are. So when you record for the snail hunt, we want you only to look at the adults that have got a complete lip. And if you look closely, I've got two babies here, and you can see that apart from being smaller, the shell just ends sharply. There's no lip, either white or black, to be seen. Of course, when you go snail hunting, you're not only going to find the two snails we're really interested in. There are lots of others around, and some of them look quite similar. Now I want to tell you something about the varieties and how to score them. And the varieties are of two sorts. Firstly, we look at the shell colour, and then we look at whether or not there are bands on the shell. Now, as it happens, all these three shells, snails in my hand, are unbanded. You can see the shell is purely one colour all over. And the categories we want you to put them in is it a yellow, like this one, pink, like this one, or brown, like this one. The other aspect of variation in these snails that we want you to look at is their bands. And here I have the three major varieties that we're asking you to record. Unbanded, which you've seen before when I showed you all the unbanded shells. Single banded or mid-banded with one band in the middle. and many banded with lots of bands. Once you've collected your snails, we want to record them. And you'll have seen the recording sheet on the website. And I collect at least all the live snails up. And we can put them back where they came from, because they're not doing any harm to anybody and we want to preserve the populations. So I just scatter them back where I'd found them. So we've completed our record card. Now we want to enter it. So we go to the website, we look at enter a record, we complete the record sheet following the instructions, and we send it off. And very soon you'll get an acknowledgement back from the MegaLab Centre telling you about your record and about the nearest records to it. Thank you.